first date ever when we first hung out, we went to visit our friend who was incarcerated in Jessup, Georgia. And I made a joke. made a joke that there was nothing there except the world's largest rubber band ball. So I bought the ring and I hid it in a rubber band ball and wrapped it up and made her go on a scavenger hunt while I was gone on a trip with the boys. And then when I got back, I waited till our anniversary and then I had her cut it open. And there it was.
So you had the ring purchased for a while?
Yeah, a few months. Can I get a Roll Tide?
You're an Alabama fan?
Yeah.
They yeah, don't let me forget. You don't let us forget.
Y'all have a long off season. Yeah.
He won't be an Alabama fan.
You're not a baby boy?
No, I'm a fan. I'm a fan.
He's like, who's number one in the polls? We're going to make it. It's 12 teams.
I have a question. Do we have to be on the watch out for any one of you guys when it comes to the reception? Is anybody going to get too lit?
Once the shirt comes off, that's when you need to really start going.
You got the detachable sleeves.
Oh, yeah, do these come off? Watch.
Oh, shit, they don't reattach.
So you taking everything off? Just going to be tie and white beater?
Just the tie.
He's the tie's going around beater. The head.
Oh, it's like, wow.
That's a good idea.
There's levels to it. There's levels to it. First the jacket comes off, then the shirt, and then eventually I say, ah, fuck it.
Who's getting married next?
Outside of
Ben?
Ben?
Yeah.
Probably.
Are you cuffed up, man?
I don't give a piss about nothing but the tide, baby! Don't give a piss about nothing but the tide!
Is there not on it?
What?
Tastes like shit.
What's the flavor of these cigars?
Dirt.
Dirt.
Essence.
She can't wash her eyes.
I hope that don't affect him down the aisle. Cause
I know, I'm worried about it. Okay. So that's okay. I have a little treat. I'm going to be like, all right.
Who was the most difficult one to raise?
Sierra. Absolutely.
Why was she the most difficult
one? What? No comment. Congratulations.
Okay, who's the funniest one?
Sierra. Sierra's answered all.
Who was the one that you was most afraid of to grow up?
Question. Aww. That doesn't seem right.
She's looking right. She's crying.
Don't look at me.
Alright. One, she's trying to fight herself. She
said, give me a sip. Give me a drink, sip.
So, baby, how's your morning?
It was good.
Smooth.
How was your morning?
Yeah, not too bad. It was good. You know, I had to deal with them, so.
Oh, God.
No, it was good. I mean, we got some pictures at the bar, and then we went to the,
nice.
The little, you know, courtyard area. Got some pics there. And
I'm excited to see the pictures.
We're going to spark up. You don't want to hear the audio.
I heard Caleb was a menace.
Yeah, Caleb. But you knew that, so.
All right, so now y'all can back up until y'all touch back to back.
Not on a
twin. So that dog is yours?
Yeah.
Oh, the dog is yours. Oh, okay. Okay.
She's going to come down here shortly for pictures.
So I was going to say she's already here. Right.
So did y'all get the dog before y'all got married?
I had the dog for a few years before I started dating.
So how did you get adjusted to a dog that big?
I love dogs. Dog. I grew up with small dogs, but I mean, if you meet this dog, she's different. So.
She's different. She's built different.
Yeah, she is built different. No, she's the sweetest dog in the world, and she made it easy. So.
Do you have to get a king-size bed just because
we
the dog?
Did.
Like, yeah. No, that was a deal. That was a deal breaker. Well, as soon as we moved, I was like, we're getting a new mattress. I can't
believe it. Oh, I love the bag and the shoes. Oh, thank you. The dress fit. I didn't have to wear the prom dress.
You said prom dress?
Yeah.
What?
My little sister has a white prom dress, and I was going to wear it as a backup. But I didn't have
You got the Vans on now?
I do. We got
the Oh, that's
so...
Hell yeah. We got it right in him. March 2024.
All right. I'm gonna get Shashi out together right
quick. Okay. My jaw's gonna hurt from smiling so much. It was hurting yesterday. Last night I was like, I gotta scowl for a second. We're actually here for Noah's birthday weekend.
Yeah. It's your birthday?
It was yesterday.
Oh, happy birthday. Happy belated.
This is his celebration.
So what, damn, I was about to say, what's happening
to
celebrate?
The
rehearsal. Yeah, the wedding.
He got to hang out with us.
Yeah.
I got invited to my present. Censorship of the
It's like, oh, it's Noah's birthday. I guess we have to invite him. Damn.
Oh, the ties look really good, y'all.
Yeah,
looking sharp.
Yeah, Noah tied every single one of ours.
Y'all know how to tie ties?
No.
I tied my own ties. Caleb tied his.
I ain't like that. That's a very sharp tie.
And then nice Colin, tie. Caleb nice tie. Tied Colin's, but yeah.
It looks so good with the checkered Vans. I actually like it a lot.
Yeah.
In there.
Is he in the right spot?
Nice. I think he is. I told him it was like rougher than that.
Back.
You're lucky it's wet. You know, you got good soil.
Oh, am I lucky? I didn't realize I was lucky today.
I see the vest. What do you think it is?
What makes you think it is though? Like,
I don't know. I've seen it like being like an old Southern tradition of like you bury a bottle of bourbon and you drink it with the wedding party and you should have good.
I've had many weddings like before, and I promise you, this is close to what a bride is thought of.
And it's in the bag so that it wasn't all like dirty when we drank it.
Thanks, guys.
We appreciate that.
I'll be here all week.
Yay!
We gotta get the bottles out.
Oh, yeah, all right. Cheers.
To the Johnsons.
Mm-hmm. Mmm. You're not a whiskey drinker either.
Mmm.
No, two.
Oh, you trying to be a model today.
Yeah, all the bridesmaids look at kind of an angry way.
So, where you going to angle that? Because you can't angle
I was going to go like that way.
Y'all don't celebrate with her. She's popping.
You think it's good?
Let's go. Make it happen. Come on. I said make it happen.
We can do a test try.
Yeah.
We can do a test try. All right.
Test try. We just go out.
Yeah. Test try. Okay. 1, 2, 3. All right. So we gonna go serious.
Are you twinkling after?
Serious?
Yeah, like,
don't
I mean, like,
emo.
Not serious, I mean, like we're actually gonna. This is gonna
okay.
be an.
This is
one.
A real one.
A real one. Yeah.
Okay.
Do whatever you like. All right. 1, 2, 3. Oh, that was tough. Stop.
Showing
your personality. Wow. Oh, y'all are so fake. Oh my God.
Individuals
by
like the magnolia
yeah.
tree, you know? Okay.
The fact you knew the name of the tree.
Caleb looked it up yesterday. I think someone did.
I thought we had something special. I'll never forgive you. It's not too late.
Hey, hell yeah, bro.
I'll drink to that, boy.
What the
fuck?
That was a good one.
We're good. Folks, bless you. Yes. It's been a minute.
Alright,
here we go.
Cheers,
it's cold.
Yeah. Okay, I need to see
my leg
out.
It's hurting.
Damn,
it's
smoking.
Oh, you were done?
Yeah.
I know, I thought he took another break.
Oh, I thought he was just hurting, though.
I know!
Nah, he's a dove chug.
He's one of the best.
Try looking.
Upon the waters, the great and
Spirit, lead me where my trust is without Proverbs 18:22 says, "He who finds a wife finds what is good and receives favor from the Lord." So please join me in giving thanks to the Lord. Let's bow. Heavenly Father, Lord, we give you glory for this time today. Lord, we know it's by your providential hand that you bring people together, so we thank you that you brought Connor and Savannah together and brought them to this point. We ask, Lord, that you bless their life and bless all the products of this union. And Lord, most of all, we ask that you retouch their hearts and give them a hunger to know and love you. And just ask your presence in this ceremony. In our time tonight, we ask you to do the same. Amen. I first got wind that I was going to have this great opportunity, and there was a sort of a reoccurring theme that kept coming up about it when I talked to Savannah and Connor about, you know, what do you want your wedding to look like? What are the things you want involved? And it was a reoccurring theme, and finally Savannah said, there's just two things that will make it a perfect wedding to me. Make it short and sweet. Okay, can you? We can do that. So that she mentioned that more than once, so we can do that. I'll never forget, you know, the first time we heard about Savannah, how excited we were and how much curiosity we had when my mom first mentioned that Connor had a serious girlfriend at the biscuit restaurant where he worked. And someone said, Connor works at a biscuit restaurant? Are you serious? What kind of biscuits do they have? I mean, are they buttermilk, those kind? Kind of biscuits and gravy. Oh, I love those. Yeah, those are great. So the cat was out of the bag. But once we met Savannah, certainly found her to be a beautiful girl, intelligent, and so sweet. She fit right in with us, and we couldn't have picked a better young lady for Connor. And we're just so pleased and so blessed to have her as part of our family. And the other thing, she brought this majestic beast with her when we first met. So that was the best of me there, too. And you could probably say the same thing about Lucky, that she's a beautiful girl, intelligent, and sweet. So that was good. So the way I see it, it's going to be an all-around good day. Connor gets to marry Savannah, and we got some biscuits coming later.
Often couples think of me.
We there? Often couples think of marriage as a box full of your hopes and dreams, all that your spouse can add to your life. Then each one begins to take from that box. You take and take until there's nothing else to take, and you're left with an empty box. Better yet, you consider your marriage the empty box that each one of you add to on behalf of the other. A steady stream of kind words, encouragement, compliments, gifts, and experiences are added by each one, ensuring that you have a box that is always overflowing.
It will be a source of strength
and a reminder of what you have together when you encounter bumps in the road. There are a lot of plans and preparations leading up to today. This was the planner here. Details carried out to make things just right, because you want this to be a memorable day for yourselves. You'll have photos and videos to look back on to remember what a special a day it was. But the most important thing for you to remember about this day is the feeling of love that you have for one another right now. So, Ann and Connor, just take a second, if you would, reflect on the feelings you have for one another right now. God once directed a despondent husband to remember the wife of your youth, not how she was when she was young, but how you felt about her then, how excited and satisfied you were with her back then. Take that love you have for each other today and make it your benchmark. add something to your marriage box as often as you can. Roll up your sleeves and be intentional about the work of marriage. Be serious about the vows you're about to take. So if you do, in 30 or 40 or 50 years from now, you'll be able to say, I love my spouse. Or today. Than I did when the day we were married. And that's our prayer for you today. Malcar and Savannah will express their intent for one another. Do you, Savannah, take Connor to be your lawfully wedded husband, to live together in matrimony, to love him, comfort him, honor him and keep him, in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, to have and to hold from this day forward as long as you both shall live? If you do, answer, I do.
I do.
Do you contradict Savannah to be your lawfully wedded wife, to live together in matrimony, to love her, comfort her, honor her, and keep her, in sickness and in health, in sorrow and in joy, to have and to hold from this day forward as long as you both shall live? If so, answer, I do. So we can have security bring the rings forward now. Anybody make any sudden moves? Connor and Savannah have chosen rings to exchange with each other as a symbol of their unending love. Connor, as you place this ring on Savannah's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed and pledge to you my love now and forever. Savannah, as you place this ring on Connor's finger, please repeat after me. With this ring, I thee wed, and pledge my love now and forever. Now by the power given to me by Connor and Savannah, I now pronounce you husband and wife, you may kiss the bride.
Talk to me, but look dead at her.
Okay.
When did you realize she was the one for you?
Oh, me either. Now, my, well, this is vow talk. This is serious.
This is vow talk.
See, but this wasn't said during the wedding, though.
You're right.
When I,
so go ahead and let her know, because she may not know this.
She knows. I told her yesterday. But I'll tell her again. I'll tell her every day for the rest of her life if she wants. It's after Shelby told me he thought we'd be good together, and I thought about it, and then every day was miserable because I couldn't be with you until I finally was. Then everything just was all right.
Savannah, when did you realize he was the one for you? Because you said yes when he asked.
When I shaved my head.
Oh my God.
When he had the mustache and he came out of fire school all chiseled. I'm just kidding.
Boy.
No. Very, very soon. We were friends, and I definitely wanted to be more than friends, but I'm glad we started as friends because we built such a good relationship and foundation. You know, I think our relationship as a couple is so much better because we started out as friends. So, but I always liked you. I always loved you as a friend.
No, I'm at like a 6 right now. I need to get to like a 9 before the shirt comes off.
A shirt comes off.
Okay. There's a wife beater under this.
A wife beater.
I'm not kidding.
Right now. Oh, you're right. No, buddy.
No, I'm not kidding. There.
Oh, this man.
It's under there. And then.
Superman shirt under
there. No. No, it's a wife beater.
When I get you, only me.
He's the guy that just—that's what he does. He gets fucked up and then arms come out.
Can you get a Sharpie and put like an ass on Superman on your shirt?
They're like the way they talk is so different than how it was earlier. They were so much chill, and I was like, we're all.
It'll be all just
push-ups, get a little pumping.
No.
So who plans on winning this
beer pong tournament?
Yes.
I'm better 1v1, but I don't know. It's risky. Neither of us have played in a minute. But in my prime, I would say I would win. I think he would agree with me.
I think she's gonna win. I don't think I'm gonna lose.
But also, if I lose, I'll be upset. He won't be upset.
Are you saying it just so you feel good? Or you
I know he's.
No, I truly think she's better at 1v1. I really think she'll beat me.
Thank you.
My name is Jim Adams, and I am Savannah's dad. First off, I want to thank everybody for coming tonight to celebrate this wonderful event for Savannah and Connor. I believe we have people who have traveled from as far away as Utah, Nebraska, Iowa, Florida, New York, South Carolina, Ohio, a lot of folks from Ohio, and probably other areas as well. So thank you all for coming tonight. Thank you, Brian and Maureen, for raising such a fine son. It's always a good thing for a father-in-law to have some things in common with his son-in-law. Luckily, Connor and I are rabid fans of the New York Jets. That is an inside joke. Connor hates the Jets. He is a long-suffering Miami Dolphins fan, and I haven't cheered for the Dolphins since the heyday of Dan Marino. It may be that the only two things that Connor and I have in common are beards and Savannah. But my friends, that is more than enough to have a strong kinship. Connor, welcome to Savannah's family. I next want to talk about Savannah. Who is Savannah Catherine Johnson? I figured I'd mess that up. It's going to take me a little bit of time to get used to that. In order to answer the question, I got to talk to you a little bit about her upbringing. Savannah was raised by a loving and competitive mother and an old school infantry Marine. That meant a steady dose of sports, primarily soccer and basketball, along with warrior training, and a healthy exposure to old school country music. From the time Savannah was in preschool until she graduated from St. Robert's Elementary in the eighth grade, her and her sisters, every morning on the way to school, were exposed to the likes of Johnny Cash, Willie Nelson, and Waylon Jennings. Some of Savannah's favorites were A Boy Named Sue by Johnny Cash, The Devil Went Down to Georgia by Charlie Daniels, The Battle of New Orleans by Johnny Horton, and one of my favorites, Big Iron by Marty Robbins.
Yeah. Hell yeah.
Most of you probably don't know most of those songs. Savannah was close enough in age to her sister Sierra that her mother and I had her play up on all of Sierra's sports teams. One could describe Sierra's style of play as blunt force trauma. In contrast, Savannah was more refined. Her style of play would best be characterized as determined, hardworking. She had a fearlessness when going against older, bigger, stronger girls. By the time Savannah was 9 years old, she was the pull-up champion in Mr. Gazda's PE class at St. Robert's. She did 11 dead hang pull-ups, which was tops in her class for boys and girls at that time. By the time Savannah was a sophomore in high school, she was a contributor on the girls' varsity basketball team. One lasting memory of that season came late in the year against South Sioux City, who was always a powerhouse in high school girls' basketball in Nebraska. It was late in the game. Savannah was handling the ball. She got fouled so hard she had to go to the sideline with a bloody nose. The assistant coach looked her over, grabbed some toilet paper, and stuffed it in her nostrils to stop the bleeding, and sent her back out on the court. Savannah walks to the free throw line and calmly sinks two free throws to give Scott Catholic the lead. Woo! That's who Savannah is. Determined, tough, resilient. Those are the traits that she took to the University of Florida, where she graduated with a bachelor's degree in sports management. Those are the same traits that have served her well in law school at Wake Forest, and I'm proud to say she's going to be graduating here in a few weeks. And those are the same traits that she brings to her marriage with Connor. A few words of advice for Savannah and Connor. And I might need to look at my notes on this. First, understand you will not be perfect. No marriage is. I think anybody who's been married for a length of time will understand that. You will both make mistakes. When you do, always remember to say, "I'm sorry," with sincerity. Also remember, God always gives us the power and the strength to get through the hard times. Learn to laugh often and together. You will find that each other's laughter can nourish each of your souls. Finally, smell the roses as often as you can. Life is incredibly fast-paced and short. Take time for yourself and each other. They say that brevity is the cornerstone of wit, and I don't want to take up any more of your evening, but I do want to leave you with these thoughts. Savannah, of all the things that I've known in my life, the greatest has been being a dad to you and your sisters. This is a special occasion that every parent dreams of for their child. I am so very proud of you, and I am so very, very happy for you and Connor. Without anything further, let's raise our glasses and toast to Savannah and Connor, may they have a long, happy, healthy, loving life together. Hear, hear.
Cheers. Went down to Georgia. He was looking for a soul to steal. He was in a bind, but he was way behind. He was willing to make a deal. When he came across this young man, sewing on a fiddle and playing it hot. And the devil jumped up on a hickory stump and said, boy, let me tell you what. I guess you didn't know it, but I'm a fiddle player too. And if you care to take a dare, I'll make a bet with you. Now you play a pretty good fiddle, boy, but give the devil his due. I bet a fiddle of gold against your soul to make I'm better.
Hi, everyone. I hope you're having a lovely night celebrating Connor and Savannah's love. My name's Sierra, for those of you that don't know me. I'm Savannah's favorite sister. I meant to make eye contact with my sister. I thought we were going to be down there, but on behalf of the bride and groom, like my dad was saying, I'd like to thank you all for traveling near and far to bear witness to their union. A special thank you to Connor's parents and my parents for creating these two lovable humans. As my dad described, Savannah and I are 15 months apart in age, so we grew up doing everything together. She was my partner in crime, my confidant in chaos, and my rock in the stormy seas of life. It's been such a blessing to witness her journey through life. Savannah has always had a knack for making challenging tasks seem effortless. Despite her incredible work ethic, I have always admired Savannah's ability to show her kind-hearted spirit, her commitment to loving others, and her dedication to those she cares for. When I met Connor, I noticed the quiet confidence he exudes. He carries himself with a calm assurance that puts others at ease. His thoughtfulness knows no bounds, whether he is offering a listening ear or lending a helping hand. The genuine nature and warm heart Connor has is special. Growing up, Savannah and I were rather protective of one another. We've always had each other's backs in various phases of life. Even when Savannah was a wee lad, she was sticking up for me on the playground. One day, some kid threw sand in my face, and let's just say Savannah was not letting it fly. I've had plenty of protective sisterly moments over the years. After getting to know Connor, I found my protective instinct at ease, which says a lot. When Savannah and Connor's paths crossed, and they began dating, I could immediately sense their connection was unique. It's always been apparent to anyone who spends time with them just how perfectly they complement each other, like biscuits and gravy. You two are blessed to have each other. Savannah, you have Connor to hold your hand through your jump scares in your beloved horror movie nights. And Connor, you have Savannah to have lightsaber battles with. I know their furry firstborn Lucky, aka Bugs, is extremely stoked, barking for joy that her parents have officially tied the knot. I love you both. Cheers to Mr. and Mrs. Johnson.
All right, guys, I'm Caleb. I'm the best man. I've known Connor for a long time. We met each other in elementary school, but we weren't friends and didn't hang out because we hated each other. So we became really, really close towards the end of high school, and then we've been close ever since. One thing I wanted to share is the first time we ever shared a bed together. It was December 23rd, 2010. sorry, Savannah, but I was there first. The most recent time that we shared a bed together, this might surprise everybody in here, but was last night. And that's a true story. Lucky laid in the bed in between us, and we were hanging off the edges, because Lucky is definitely the princess. But to get on a more serious note, I didn't really write anything down, because I can't read very well. So I wanted to just come up here and kind of say some things from the heart. Connor's one of the best friends I've ever had in my life. He's always been there for me through thick and thin. I've done a lot of stupid things. He's done a lot of stupid things. And every time we tell each other about it, and we write in our diaries, and it's a really, like, it's a great connection. It's a deep connection. I can share who I am. I know it sounds really weird. I shouldn't have added the diary part, but the connection between him and I is really awesome. It's something not a lot of guys get with other guys, and I'm not going to get into all that. But the first time I met Savannah, I was really happy because she was cool, and I didn't feel like I had to be somebody else when I was around her, and he didn't have to be somebody else when he was around her too, which was really the more important thing, because who really cares about me, right? And most recently, they came out to visit me in Utah. And I knew then and there that this was the best thing that's probably ever happened to Connor because of the love that they shared and how fantastic their bond is. I've seen Connor in a lot of highs in his life, and I've seen him in a lot of lows. But the version that I see now with him and Savannah together is the best version I've ever seen. With that being said, I was gonna come up here and probably swear there was a lot of bachelor party bets on whether or not I was gonna come up here and be very crude, so I didn't, and I did a good job. So we're just gonna have a toast here. And this is gonna be directed at Connor. If you wanna repeat it, you don't have to. If you're under the age of 18, don't listen. But Connor, don't fuck it up.
Caleb, go to the room and get it.
Why am I doing this?
Because you're doing it really well.
It's too late now.
Because you're doing well.
I don't know. Gio won't shut up about how I messed his up.
Shut up. I said two things about it. You got that on camera, right? I said two things about it.
Calm down.
I hope you also got on camera you begging for him to, like, film your micro penis. No, your camera's good enough. You can zoom in enough.
My girlfriend says it's huge.
It's all about the angle.
Listen, no, if she has the same...
It's a perfect size.
The bush makes it smaller.
She says the bigger ones hurt, so it's all good. It's all good. There's not going to be another group like us, is there? Like,
now he's dead.
KSM! KSM!
Wise men say only fools rush in, but I can't help falling in love with you. Oh, like a river flows to the sea, darling, so it goes. Some things are meant to be. Won't take my hand, take my whole life too. For
Major.